Hello everyone. I hope my voice is audible. Good evening everyone. Good evening everyone. Is my voice audible? Can you please confirm? Okay, sir. So we all assembled for quick revision for your paper number 7, which is strategic management and IT, sir. So I am assigned for SM syllabus. So let's start, sir. So let's start with question number 1, ma. Question number 1, which I will be now talking about, is objectives of business. So presently we are focusing on chapter number 1, ma, objective of business. So I'm not wasting any time in formal introduction. Let's make optimum utilization of the available hours, ma. Okay, so let's go with question number 1. If possible, try to write along with me. That would be more useful for you people also, sir. So mean bit disturbing in can you please confirm, ma, everyone, is voice audible? Can I go forward? Okay. Tell you, sir. So objective of business is what my first question is, sir. Sir, can I say, when we are doing a business, we definitely do this business with some objective, sir. Similarly, when we are doing this CA course, can I say we are doing this with some objective? Agreed or not, sir? Yes. So every time when we are doing the business, we do with some objective, sir. Now question is, what are those objectives, sir? Now, sir, our material says objective of a business cannot be constant, or objective of business cannot be a sole objective, sir. Business objectives will be multiple. So business will never have a sole objective. Business will have multiple objectives. Now, whatever question which I am now discussing, sir, it is important from your MCQ point of view, and also it is important from your essay question point of view, sir. If at all it comes for essay, it will be shortcut a 5 marks question, sir. MCQ also, it is equivalently important, sir. Okay, now, so let's see. So first conformity what we got is, business possesses single objective, or business possesses multiple objective. So answer is, business possesses multiple objectives. First point, sir. So this is how you have to reproduce your answer. If at all a question comes, what are the objectives of business, sir? Now this is how you have to write, sir. So first point is, business do not have a sole objective, business possess multiple objectives. Second point, sir. Sir, objective of business is dependent on one concept called product life cycle. Objective of business is dependent on one concept called product life cycle. Now, sir, what is product life cycle? Details of this is given in third chapter. Details of this is given in third chapter when we read one concept or one part called portfolio concept. So when we read portfolio concept, sir, usme one concept which we'll be reading is product life cycle. So again, I'm just telling both points, sir, if at all you people are writing. First point is, business do not possess single objective, business possess multiple objectives. Second, the objectives of business is dependent on one concept called product life cycle, sir. Next. Third, objectives of business keeps on changing. Objectives of business keeps on changing. Keeps on changing. Depending upon the stages, or you can say objective of business keeps on changing depending on stage of product in product life cycle. Objective of business keeps on changing depending on stage of product in product life cycle. Now, if at all you people have gone through this concept, sir, this is how it looks. Agreed? So how many stages are there in product life cycle, ma? Can anybody confirm? You all are attending revision class, so obviously you should know something about PLC, sir. So can anybody quickly comment how many stages are there in PLC? I'm waiting for your answer, ma'am. Can anybody confirm, ma'am? Four stages. Okay. So what are those four stages, ma'am? Five stages, Arun Reddy. Here itself, phasak ho gaya aap log. So four stages is what the answer is, ma. But can you tell me, sir, what are those four stages? Saurabh says introduction stage. Second is your growth stage. Third is your maturity stage. And fourth is your decline stage, sir. So this is how this concept goes, sir. So we have four stages in PLC, sir. Okay. Now, so what did we write? Yes, sir. So we have four stages, ma, and these are those four stages. What did we write, sir? Objectives of business are multiple. It depends on one concept called PLC. Stage of product keeps on changing in PLC. So business objective will also keeps on changing, sir. If at all somebody asks me, sir, I am a newcomer in the market, sir. I am at introduction stage. So at this stage, what could be the objective of business, sir? Do you think any newcomer in the market would be more interested in earning profits? Answer is no. Sir, can I say his intention would be to penetrate, his intention would be to stay in the market as long as possible. Agreed, sir? His intention would be to stay in the market as long as possible. He would like to remain in the market as long as possible. Agreed or not, sir? Sir, in other words, this objective is called survival. This objective is called what, sir? Survival. So this is what my first objective of business is. So can I say survival matlab kya, sir? Survival is nothing but will, anxiety to penetrate in market, or better word is will oblique anxiety to remain in market as long as possible. So do you think at survival stage intention would be to earn profits? Answer is no. Sir, here intention would be to at least, here intention would be to at least recover the cost. And when I say cost, I mean fixed cost. In costing language, we call this as a break-even point, sir. Okay, very good. But do you think we will be always looking for survival only, sir? We will be always looking for break-even only? Answer is no. So can I say at one point of time, business want something more than survival? Now, people, please keep on responding, ma, if at all you are understanding any doubts, etc., sir. So two-way interaction will always help, sir. Okay. Now, so second point is growth. Can I say at a growth stage, mostly business looks for what, sir? Expansion. Mostly business looks for what, sir? Expansion, sir. Sir, do you think this is a dynamic objective? Answer is yes. So companies which are looking for expansion, sir, they are highly dynamic, sir. Next. Sir, growth can be in many forms. Growth can be in many forms. What could be the forms, sir? In what manner growth is possible? Now, some people believe growth is only possible in terms of profit. Answer is no. Can I say growth can happen in terms of your asset size? Sir, growth can happen in terms of your revenue. This is one example which you can say. Sir, growth can be in terms of profits. Sir, growth can be in terms of geographical area. Sir, growth can be in form of customer base. So growth can be in many forms. This is what we have to understand, sir. Okay, very good. Sir, next one. Can I say, do you think growth is an ever continuing objective? Expansion bolo, or you can also call this as growth, sir. Do you think growth is an ever continuing objective, ma? I want answer, sir. Do you think growth is an ever continuing objective? क्या आपको लगता है ग्रोथ इज एन एवर कंटिन्यूइंग ऑब्जेक्टिव? नो. कैन आई से फॉर एग्जांपल स्कूल डेज में सर, इनिशियली यू गॉट 10th रैंक, एक पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम के बाद यू गॉट 5th रैंक, नाउ यू गॉट 1st रैंक. नाउ कैन आई से व्हाट इज नेक्स्ट? व्हाट इज नेक्स्ट? नाउ नेक्स्ट देयर इज नो ग्रोथ सर. सो कैन आई से दैट इज व्हाट आई मीन बाय मैच्योरिटी? That is what I mean by maturity, sir. So don't you think if your company ka product, if your company ka business is at matured position, sir, can I say they will be more aiming at stability? They will be aiming more at what, sir? Stability. So this would be my third objective, sir. But remember, sir, sometimes exam mein question comes. Stability is a do nothing objective. Do you think if company is going for stability objective, it means it is a do nothing objective, sir? Do you agree with this line? If company goes with a stability objective, do you think it is a do nothing objective? Answer is no. Even if you are at rank 1, can I say for next exam you have to still study? For next exam you have to still study, sir. Correct hai na bhai? Just because hai na, you have achieved first rank in this exam, that does not mean every time you will achieve that, sir. So can I say improvements are possible? Okay, now sir, maybe hai na, major improvements are not required, but minor improvements are always possible, sir. Okay, now what could be the improvements, sir? Can I say in terms of product ka redesign? Do you think even though you are number one, can I say you can still look for some improvements in your product, sir? Sir, in terms of adding features to your product, in terms of reducing your unnecessary cost, reduction in cost, sir. Okay, aise we can write many points in this, sir. So I'm not writing entire thing, ma, because it's a rapid revision. So there is something called learning for the first time, then there is something called revision. Now we are at third level, sir. We are talking about rapid revision, though hai na, I will be not that rapid, sir. Wherever question is important hai na, I would like to ensure that detailly we are going through, sir. Okay sir, shall we go forward, sir? Up to here things are clear? Anybody any doubts? So till now, if somebody ask me, sir, can you tell me what are the objectives of business? So my answer would be, objectives of business are point 1 survival, point 2 expansion, point 3 stability. If people are writing along with me, please tell me, sir. Once it is done, let me know, sir. Okay, sir. Now, so we have written three objectives. Now, fourth objective, let us try to understand, sir. Now, remember, sir, this is a super, super important question. If at all you see alternate attempts, or for that matter, every attempt, sir, you will be finding one question from this particular area, sir. Either in the form of MCQ or in the form of direct questions, sir. Now, ek time mein, there used to be something called comment related questions also. But from last 2-3 attempts, what I am observing in ICAI ka pattern is ki that comment type of questions they have removed, sir. So they are directly asking you 5 marks questions, sir. So if at all that happens, that is a good thing for students also. Now, you need not think that much while answering, sir. So more or less you understand the answer, write down in the exam, sir. Now, fourth objective which we have to write is efficiency. Sir, efficiency matlab kya, sir? Now, can I say any business, whether you are at start stage, whether you are at growth stage, whether you are at end stage, sir, jo bhi ho, sir. Sir, at any point of time, you would like to reduce unnecessary cost. Agree? People say money saved is money earned, sir. So we would like to reduce your unnecessary cost. Sir, this is possible by means of optimum utilization of resources. When you read 6th chapter, you will be finding one more word for efficiency, sir, which is doing things rightly. Now, when I take regular class, I don't tell this line upfront because I have to cover 6th chapter also. But I am assuming that some knowledge you might be having, sir. That's the reason I am telling you right now, sir. So, 6th chapter mein, we have one concept called effectiveness and efficiency. So there, if you remember, here the word used is doing right things. Here they use a word doing things rightly, which we have written here, sir. Okay. And the most important objective, your fifth objective of business, is profitability. Fifth objective of business is profitability, sir. Okay, now, sir, sometimes question comes on profit, sir, saying that is profit the sole objective of business? Is profit the sole objective of business? People should answer. Is profit the sole objective of business? Do you agree with this, sir? Answer is no. If this was the sole objective, can I say phaltu ka time pass kiye hum log? 1, 2, 3, 4 kyun pade, sir? Why did we read these 4 points? Obviously, answer is no. So profit is not the sole objective. But do you think profit is one of the most important objective? One of the most important objective? Answer is yes. This line mein I agree, sir. Sir, tell me, sir, business number 1, business number 2. If business number 1 earns a profit of 50 crores, profit I am talking about, sir. If business number 2 earns a profit of 80 crores, kya lagta hai aapko, sir? Which business has done proper, sir? Or which business is doing good? Which business is doing good, sir? Business 1 or business number 2? Respond karo bhai. Business 1 has earned a profit of 50 CR. Business 2 has earned a profit of 80 CR. Obviously, Business 2 has done proper, sir. Now, question ye hai, how did you find out, sir? Can I say by means of profits? So, can I write one line? Can I write one line? Profit acts, now I'm using a word, profit acts as a, now these are keywords. Now, most of the time you find faculties, and any faculty for that matter, sir, they utter a words key in IT, in SM, you have to use keywords. Now, what are those keywords? Now, this is what I am writing, sir. Now, can I say everywhere I am writing those keywords which you have to reproduce in your exam, sir? Profits acts as a financial yardstick. Profits acts as a financial yardstick for measuring performance of business. Now, what is yardstick, sir? Anything by which you measure. Anything by which you measure. Can I go forward, sir? Up to here, things are clear. So, if somebody asks you how many objectives are there, sir, so our answer should be there are 5 objectives of business. Now, can you quickly tell me what are those 5 objectives, ma? Quick summary. What are those 5 objectives? Now, we will not butterfly, sir. Now, remember the diagram which I told you, sir. Start mein ho, toh can I say you will look for survival. Aage badh chuke ho, toh you will look for growth / expansion. Can I say at one point of time, you will stop, that is stability. Sir, then I said efficiency. And then I am using a word profit. Okay. Right, sir. Very good. So, exam mein, what way mein, they can ask you a question, sir. If it is an MCQ, they may give you options and saying what, sir? Ki dash is not an objective of business. So, maybe they may give you 4 options and now you have to find out which is correct, sir. Now, I don't believe in memory techniques, ma. So maybe people will go with mnemonics, P, G, whatever it is. But I don't believe in all those mnemonics, sir. Unless otherwise, we cannot develop one scenario and remember. Because simple as, sir, too many memory techniques will cause problem when you are revising in, what you say, for your exams also and in exam hall also, sir. Okay? Chal ye, sir. So whatever it is, if at all you are comfortable with mnemonics, sir, you may always go with, but I believe in developing a scenario. So I have developed a scenario. Now you may remember, sir. Okay, bacha? Chaliye, sir. Can I go forward, sir? Now, here one important MCQ may appear in exam, sir. Now, what is this? Let me write down. If you say yes, okay, chaliye, sir. Sir, tell me, sir. Every business may, or better word I will use, sir. Every entity may, any entity for that matter, every entity may, sir, dash you may find. dash you may find, but dash you may not find. You may not find. Now, objectives, five objectives we have already studied. Now, in this five objectives, you have to fill here one objective, here one objective. In every entity, you may find this objective, but you may not find this objective. What could be the answer, sir? Or dash may be a universal objective. Dash may be a universal objective. Dash objective may be possessed by every organization, and dash objective may not be possessed by every organization. Can I say whether you are a profit making entity or non-profit entity? Whether you are a profit making entity or a non-profit entity, sir, hamesha aapko efficiency lagega, sir. Agreed?